Good morning, YouTube, or afternoon, and welcome to the Fantasy Forecast Optimal Cash Lineups and Sample Tournament Lineup for March 1st, 2016. You can review all of my projections for individual players for today in the previous video. Let's just jump right in and start with the Roto Grinders Optimal Cash Lineup. I'm going to focus over there now. Okay, that should be a good view for you guys. Okay, so Roto Grinders today, their cash lineup, or their optimal cash lineup, it starts with D'Angelo Russell and Sloan in point guard. We've got Wade and Batum in the shot guard, Deng and Winslow in the small forward, Draymond Green and Millsap in power forward, and Gasol in for the center. And they have projected this one at 299 today. I'll just mention that they had the best projections by a mile yesterday among free providers, but that won't necessarily carry through to today. Okay, moving on. This is the Roto Wires optimal lineup. It was just recently updated to reflect for Kobe being out, and this is what they've given us. They have projected this at 293, when we have Walker and Payton at the point guard, Depot and Batum at shot guard, Anthony and Bogdanovic at small forward, Draymond Green and Davis at power forward, and Horford at center. Okay, and again, they projected that at 293. Okay, so let's move on to Fantasy Pros. Fantasy Pros today is running us with Curry and Presley in the point guard position, Batum and Matthews in the shot guard position, Anthony and Harkless at the small forward, Millsap and Green at the power forward, and Jefferson for center. And they projected this at 285. And finally, Daily Fantasy Cafe. Daily Fantasy's Cafe's optimal lineup for today is Lillard and Russell at the point guard position, Dwayne Wade and McCollum at shot guard, Anthony and Iguodala at small forward, Millsap and Teletovic at power forward, and the center, Anthony Lynn. Okay, now let's move on to my own cash lineup that I put together for you guys. I have Dragic and Sloan at the point guard position. And you can see already $5.50, $50, $2.50, $50, $1.50, $50. I throw a $1 swat in just to track how it goes against that. I've noticed that the cash scores are getting very close to the GPP scores, and this is just a test for that. So forget about that dollar. This is a cash entry. So going on to cash, I have Dragic and I have Sloan at point guard. The Bulls are near the bottom of the league against the point guard position, and a limping Rose today, or a substitute more because he'll be on limited minutes, they're not going to keep up with Dragic's likely 35 minutes of court time. I love him here for 30-plus fantasy points tonight. Sloan is obviously a little cheaper with a play, but he's not a minimum guy, and he's here because with Joe Johnson gone, he's picked up all the slack. Can anyone see him getting even a few more minutes now that Ellington's going to be out tonight too? I like him for 25 tonight. Easy. Easy. There could be money left at any position tonight, too, based on the weird who might play or who might not play news today. So if that's the case, I'm just going to go ahead and give you guys extra options here. Like, go ahead and consider Kemba Walker here, because cash games are likely to be all over Lillard, and you'll save money with comparable performance from him against the defense-hobbled Suns tonight. Okay, moving on to shot guard, I have Klay Thompson and Depot. If Curry is out, and that's what this lineup is based on for the moment, it sure looks like he's going to be. Klay stands to become the center of the offense that Curry usually runs. Think of that game against the Clippers a week and a half ago when he put up 50 fantasy points. Yeah, that could happen again, but even if it doesn't, the floor is totally safe with Curry out. Rounding out with Depot, that's the easy call for cash today at the position. Who else can the Magic use with Harris gone and now Fournier on the mend? You'll need to watch and confirm Fournier doesn't play to get the most value from this pick, but even if you miss the news on that, Depot is still highly likely to turn value today, even if he doesn't get the court usage to exceed it. Like before, we don't know how the injuries are going to play out, so keep Wade in mind at this position. He stands to do quite well with Bosch out, and JJ hasn't taken any of his time over there, and he's got a good matchup for his position. Okay, it's small forward. I've got Carmelo and Bogdanovic. Carmelo is not Curry or Westbrook anymore, but he's still an elite player, and on a tough night for finding studs, the price just below $9,000 is a great place to park salary for his expected 44 fantasy points. Bogdanovic, though, looks a lot like a GPP kind of selection, but he's in cash today because of the Nets' horrible situation. They have to use these cheap guys for most of the night simply because of all their injuries. And believe me, it's a wonderful play against the Lakers as well, with all fantasy players know that. Your third option, instead of either of these guys, if they don't work out for some reason, take a look at Hezonja at minimum. If Fournier sits, he'll end up being the starter. Okay, at power forward, I have Draymond Green and Randle today. I love Green in the absence of Curry, and I'm really hoping they give the MVP some rest today and let Green and Thompson just carry all of Golden State's offense. Again, this play is dependent on Curry sitting, but if he does, it looks golden. Randle might look a little questionable to you guys, but regardless of Kobe playing or not, when he gets 25 or 30 minutes a night, and it's on the high end when Kobe sits. Forgetting about the minutes, let's remember who this Laker is playing, the banged-up Nets. I really think we're going to see scoring in the game all night long, and I'm expecting Randle to give us 32 fantasy points tonight. For your option, in case something doesn't work, look at Thad Young because he's still in a great spot with Joe Johnson gone. And on the cheaper end, David Lee is worth a strong look even though he's just more on bench minutes right now. Finally, at center, I have Horford today. This is a history repeats itself play. We're banking on Curry taking some rest. And the last time they played, even with Curry, he wildly exceeded value and completely destroyed Draymond Green and Bogut. He just ran all over them. And I don't see that changing much, especially if Curry's gone, because they're going to have to do minor adjustments with him out. If you find yourself with money here, consider Gasol, but you got to realize that Derrick Rose is playing, so that could cut a little bit of his... it could. Okay, and so that's your optimal cash lineup for me from today. Now, quickly, we're going to go on to a GPP lineup. And you can see I have this GPP also in a $5 cash league, but it basically, these are my free roll, my shots, and the reason why I do a cash entry on it, guys, is I'm hedging my bets. If I lose, but it's still a good thing, I'll take $9 off of 8 in bets. Slowly grind out your wins, guys. That's how this matters, even when you're trying to take a big stab. Let's go to the $2 shot. It'll be easier to dig it up. Here we go. Okay, so for today's GPP, at point guard, we have Dragic and Williams. Dragic, I've explained, but Williams is in here because Kobe is out today, and D'Angelo should hit his stride with the extra court time. Shot guard doesn't change here because Curry still looks unlikely to play, so the choices here are Wade, Depot, and Klay. Wade's biggest problem is the inconsistency, and when he does give us 45 fantasy points, it doesn't seem like it was worth it at 7,600. With Rose back to push Wade a bit on defense too, I'm taking Klay and Depot again, even though it's GPP. At small forward, I have Deng and Bogdanovic. This is a GPP, and that's why I don't want Carmelo at a basically a 5x projection. Since this is a moonshot, I'm taking Deng to have a wonderful 37-point fantasy night, completely exceed value against the Butlerless Bulls, and round it out with Bogdanovic, where the injury news to the Nets just keeps on adding to his time. And he's got that great Laker matchup. So at this point now, there's a lot of cash left. So we're just piling on Draymond Green and banking on Curry sitting right there, power forward. And then we're going to drop in Thad Young, who has that great matchup with the Lakers today, too. And then we're going to round it out with Gasol. And even though I just mentioned him a second ago and said, you know, it's only projecting 44. You know, he put up an insane 67 fantasy points a couple days back. I do not expect that again. But he is sitting in a good spot if he goes past projections to get 50, 55 fantasy points again. Okay, so there's your cash and GPP lineups for today. Thanks so much for watching. Please subscribe for notices on new videos and follow me on Twitter at MikeMiller78 for the latest news, injury information, and lineup changes. Have a great day, guys. Go out, go win some money.